Christina Hines, Corporate Communications Officer at the T.M. Marischal Community College. Our program is in collaboration with GIS. In our program today, we have a very special guest from the T.M. Marischal Community College, the Deputy Registrar, Mrs. Marva Neptune. We want to say to you, welcome, Ms. Neptune.
Thank you very much.
And we take you from where you are to where you want to go is the theme of TAMCC, and she is one of the driving forces behind all that takes place at TAMCC as it relates to exams, records, admissions, communications, etc. And so today we will be talking a little bit about all these different aspects. But to begin, we want Mrs. Neptune to say to us just a little about her experience at TAMCC in her capacity as Deputy Registrar.
All right. Well, it has been a good experience at TAMCC. It's always a good thing to watch students excel and to see them move from one point, as we say, we take you from where you are to where you want to be. It's always exciting to see them grow professionally as students. We know that they will be going out in the workplace. Some of them would be moving on to earn degrees, bachelor's level, or at the master's level, eventually some of them at PhD. And it's always good to be a part of that experience. And we want the students to know that we care for them at TAMCC. And we will do everything that we can to make that a possibility. But there are some things that we want them to know as well. And this is why I'm here today, to help explain that to them and to anybody who is interested in our programs at the college.
Okay. Now, when we're looking at your experience, like you explained, and that which the motive is of your department, mm-hmm. will you say that for the past few years that you have been at TAMCC, you have seen improvements?
Very much so. We were doing things in a cake way, you could consider it, because, you know, the college is growing. We had TAMCC forming from a number of institutions coming together and to create one college. And as whereas in the past, you just had different institutions, like, you know, you had St. Patrick Campus, you had Maribor, you had Grenier Teachers College, and all of these things all coming together to make one college and to offer associate degrees. So things have changed, and with that, you'd find that, you know, there are things you would have done previously that you need to change as we look into best practices, what is out there, what we need to focus on so that we can be seen as accredited or in terms of our programs, or that we can be seen as competitive in terms of students going out there and pursuing other programs, things like that. So we've changed. We've changed some of our programs. We've added more associate degrees. We've changed the process of application and registration, our examination process. We've made a lot of changes in these areas to better TAMCC and for the betterment of Grenada on a whole.
Okay. You mentioned improvement, you mentioned better processes and mm-hmm. all of that. When I look back at TAMCC, for example, in 1998, 1999, 2000, it was a school where it was highly subscribed, meaning that most students who complete secondary school education mm-hmm. attend TAMCC.
That's right.
Or most of us from the Grenadian population, we could say that mm-hmm. we went to TAMCC. And the classrooms were very filled during those times. Mm-hmm. Would you say that there's an increase in applications now? And if there is, has TAMCC done anything to be able to take in or to accommodate such numbers?
Well, yes, we've seen an increase. Well, it fluctuates, but the period you reference, we've seen an increase in the application process. If you would realize before, even as early as the 80s, once you leave secondary school, you go get a job. Students opted to do what we consider A-levels, mm-hmm. and so it was expensive even though it's not very, very far away, it was expensive for parents to send their children to, well, you know, national college, as we call it. But gradually, as we started offering associate degrees and we now go under the name T.A. Marshall Community College, you find more and more people. Matter of fact, we have to study trends, and you notice that in terms of education, that's the in thing. Everybody wants their degree. Right. Everybody, they're beginning to understand the value of education. And as a result of that, you would find more and more people coming in to look at our programs, what we offer, certificate programs, technical programs, competency-based programs. So you've seen an increase in that desire to want to go beyond secondary school and to come into our local college, the only loan tertiary education institution in Grenada, to get their associate degree. And you know, it's a wonderful opportunity for Grenadians. It's something, I mean, we know the value of education. It's something that we really, really admire, the way the trend, rather than just leaving school at your form five and having 6, 7, even 12 O levels, you realize that you have to go beyond.
Okay. So we have seen that there's a generation shift to persons who are thinking beyond just secondary school. Right. While we're on that, TAMCC is at a period now where they are making plans and arrangements for the new school year.
Yes.
Can you tell us a little bit about the application process, what time it is, how can persons apply, and things like that?
Sure. We and you reference what are some of the changes that we have, and one is our application process. We used to have the application coming into TAMCC for admissions for the new intake of every year. We have a new intake of students late, and that is a problem for us.
Okay.
Recently, we have changed, and we are asking everyone who is interested in TAMCC to come into the college much earlier, apply. And so this year, we're asking that all person interested, whether you've come in from the secondary school, whether you've left school, but you want to do a program in TAMCC, apply now. The application process begins now, and the application fee, non-refundable, is $50. So if you want more information, you can always go to our website. You can always call the admissions office or the office of the registrar. We can provide you with more details, but you can apply now to the college. Applications are available online, and it's available at the college. So we're appealing to persons out there, if you really, really want to get in, to do so now. And it's cheaper for you to do it now.
Okay.
All right? Later, after April 29, you will have a late application fee of $100. Well, it's an additional 50. So take up the advantage of the opportunity now to apply and pay the $50 non-refundable fee and get your application in. If you have your result slip, CSEC result slip, you can submit it with your application. You will need to submit the original along with a copy. We don't keep originals. We would give you back after we scrutinize the original. And you may need to submit your birth certificate again with a copy. We need to see the original. We'll give you back the original. We don't keep the original. So the application process for the 2016-2017 intake begins now. And we're talking about starting college during the month of August, the last week in August. But we need to process these applications before, so that when the students are ready, those who are waiting on results, we have them in our system and we are able to process them very smoothly.
Okay, nice. A lot of persons are of the idea that when they apply, they are automatically into TAMCC and they are ready to start classes. Is that really the case?
No, and we want to clear that up. There's a difference between an application process and a registration process. If you apply to the college, you are showing intent. I want to come in. But remember, we have to look at your results, and there is a minimum minimum entry requirement for the college. So if you have 5 CXEs, including English, then you are able to get into a program of studies. Mind you, there are some programs that require math, like natural science and some of the technical programs. But generally speaking, once you have your 5 CSEC or GCE, including English, so English is mandatory. And we want to emphasize this because we get a lot of students and people who want to come in and they don't have the English, but it's mandatory. So if you don't have it, you may have a problem.
Okay, you mentioned that the application deadline for the first fee is April 29th. Anything right after that will be $100. But you also mentioned before that persons usually apply late.
Yes.
Are there any other reasons why you think persons are applying so late?
They can't make up their mind. They don't know whether they should, you know, come to college. They might be weighing different options. Maybe it's an issue with money. Some of them, they don't know the results, their results, and because they think they didn't do well, they say, well, let me wait and see. And that is a problem, because what happens when you wait is that we may or may not have space in the program for you. So, you know, you have to be early to get an opportunity to get into the program. So waiting might be, you know, helpful to you, but in the end, it may be a bit harmful in a sense that you may not get into the program that you want to get into because you're late and we have, you know, so much other persons applying and getting in.
Right.
So you want to be careful with that.
So that's kind of like a disadvantage of applying late, that you may not get into the program that
you may not get in.
Desire.
Because we don't have unlimited space in the program. We have, you know, classrooms and classroom limits and, you know, and program limits. So we have to know how many persons we are accepting into a program, because we have classes for the program we can oversubscribe for these places. Yeah.
When you look at the school year and when it starts, and you look at the time that results come out, is that something that poses a challenge to the college when it's time to register for the students to have their exam slips on time for registration?
Very much so. Remember, if you apply to a university, you need to start school at a certain time. And if we don't have your results, it means we can't accept you. Unfortunate for us, our intake starts close to the time when the student's results come out. And because of that, we always have this rush. And that's why we insist on submitting the applications early. Because you have a rush, what happens is that when the students come in and they don't have their results, we can't do anything for them, because we can't say, well, I'll take you in and put you in a program and you don't have it. It's just chaotic. So what we are asking, especially the principals of the secondary schools, if they can possibly make available the schools to be open, have the schools open during that time to facilitate the process of giving the students a result slip so they can come to us.
Right.
Now, students come to us with something marked on a piece of paper, or they come with their phone and showing us, our university or college cannot operate in that manner. We need something official. Last year, the Ministry of Education worked well with the students and with TAMCC, whereby the students, they had a problem with getting their results, and they were able to go up to the ministry and they got something official. I know that the ministry, although they would want to, it is chaotic for them as well. So if the schools could open so that the students can receive them, because they're saying that, you know, they went to the schools and they can't get it, the schools are closed and things like that. But I know the schools, they have been trying, some of them. So we are insisting, we are appealing that they work with us, knowing that the students need the results to get to college so that they can open and make the results available to them, and that will help us nicely.
Okay, great. A lot of persons who do not have an idea what college is like, college registration and application and all of those things, might be saying to themselves, but why do they need so much time to do registration? Can you tell us a little bit about the process of registration and why it's a time-consuming process?
Right, because you would have or school, college, for us, we run semesters. And you run semesters based on a number of weeks.
Mm-hmm.
So for August to December, we have 15 weeks, and well, 16 in the sense that 1 week is for exam. And in order to get all the your hours in, the required hours to get your credit, you must cover the weeks. If we start too late, that means we cannot cover the semester in sufficient time to cover all the topics under your course.
Right.
And so we are shortchanging the students. So because the results come out late, there is an influx, quite a number of students coming in at the same time to register. And that's what makes it so pressurized, because we have a situation where we have to get you in by a certain time, and your result is coming in close to the time we have to get you in.
Right.
So that's why it appears to be chaotic. Other than that, it's not that chaotic. The only thing is that we need a chance to assess your results and to ensure that you get into the appropriate program.
Okay.
Because a lot of times you have to be sure, sometimes we do interviews, because we have to be sure that you are getting into the program that you are comfortable with, that you like. Because sometimes you have students getting into programs because my friend doing it, so I'm going to do it too. Mm-hmm. And then you have a situation where in the middle of the semester they want to transfer, they will have lost a semester, and they have to take longer to finish because the new program, you have to fulfill the requirement for the new program, and it will not take you just 2 years, it will take you 2.5 years, and in some cases 3.
Right.
So we have to take our time and make sure that the students are guided properly to get into the program that they really want to get into or should get into based on what they want, not their parents or not their friends.
Okay, well, while we're on that topic, a regular school year should take how much time or how many credits students should earn towards graduation?
Right, really, we allow 15 to 18 credits, but we try to keep them within 15. Now, if you have performed very well and an assessment is made and we realize that you can handle more than 15, we'll allow up to 18. If by the first semester your GPA can only get a 4,
right.
But if you get like you're making 3.5, 3.3, 3.4, we realize that you know you can take an overload, so you would be permitted to do an overload.
Okay.
But you, and for every semester, the minimum, well, you can do less if you don't want to finish in the 2 years, but you should take about 15, and those with permission could take 18.
Right.
In the summer, for the year, you have two 16-week semester, and then you have a 7 week during the summer, whereby you do 6 weeks of classes and a 1 week of exams. And within that, during that summer period, you're allowed only 9 credits because
okay.
it's you realize there's a shortest period of time. You go into class more
packed.
Regularly and everything is packed. So you have to be careful because we don't want to overload the students and then they can't handle. So we have to be careful with that. Yeah.
Okay. Now, through the process, the student life process, students might be kind of concerned about the idea of not getting a C.
Mm-hmm.
We are aware that a passing grade
mm-hmm.
is a C.
Mm-hmm.
I want you to just explain to our viewers what is expected if a child does not obtain that C within a certain semester or a period of time. What needs to be done? What should a child do in that case?
For you to graduate from the T. Marishu Community College successfully, you must pass your majors with a C, and you must pass your gen eds. That's a mandatory program requirement, the core courses with a C.
Yeah.
So let's say you would start this semester, and by the end you realize you're on a D, you could do a resit. All right, we allow you to do a resit.
Right.
And a resit, you can only obtain a C. If you sit the exam. So because you would have had a second chance at the exam, we don't allow you to get the highest possible grade, which is an AA plus, right. You know, or A. But we allow you to actually resit, and the highest grade you can get is a C. But you have options. You can also retake the course if you want.
Oh.
But you have to pay to retake the course. If you fail outright, you have to retake. You're not allowed a resit at all.
Okay.
But you can retake the course if you want, or you can opt to resit and get a C. But sometimes students don't have the time, or the load for the next semester, it's a lot. And so they prefer to do the resit and then, you know, try to see if they can up the grade. But you can't graduate with anything less than a C in your majors and electives.
Yeah. Okay, right. What would you say, well, maybe we should look at the student handbook. I was kind of looking at if there is any form of documentation that the students can follow, mm-hmm. to understand the school rules and regulations.
Mm-hmm.
So I want you to explain to us a little bit about the importance of the student handbook.
Right. The student handbook is what guides the student's life at the college. Makeup exam, resits exam, you want to appeal a grade, change, if your grade needs to be changed for whatever reason, it guides the students. We've been printing and issuing them to students, but because of cost,
right.
We put them the book online. We noticed that, however, that students, they make a lot of mistakes, and we don't think that they should make them, because all the rules regarding their academic life is in the student handbook. So we want to appeal to them. Please, please look online at our TAMCC website and go to the student handbook and read. We find that students are not reading enough. They are not aggressive enough, and they don't know enough when they should know, because the information is available to them. It's on the website, and you can look at it many times. You're not, you know, you can't lose it.
Right.
So it's always available. Once you have access to the internet, just go and look at the book. Everything that you need to know. And the reason why we're stressing this, I'm stressing this, is because we have situations where some students are not able to graduate because they have a grade less than C, and they did not know that the pass grade was a C,
right.
or is a C.
Right.
And the thing is that you would send this to their emails, you would send this information, put it online, on the website, post it on the notice boards, and for some reason some students still don't know. So we want that it's in the handbook. Of course we have to update it all the time, because policies, as you know, it's a dynamic. It changes, and we have to update it from time to time, but generally you have the basic information there. It seldom changes. There are some changes, but yeah.
Okay, so as we can see, the student handbook would guide us in terms of all that we need to, as students, mm-hmm. the student life, as to what
yes.
they need to do as a student regarding mm-hmm. their grades and
That's
subjects
correct.
And so on. As it relates to makeup exams, students tend to mix up what is a makeup and what is a receipt. Can you explain to us what is the difference between a makeup and a receipt?
Right. So the student... For students who, for whatever reason, did not pass an exam, and I explained the receipt process already.
Mm-hmm.
If you didn't pass for whatever reason, with a C minus, a D, or a D plus, you're allowed a receipt.
Right.
I've said before that you attempt the exam again, with permission, of course, and you can get a C. The makeup exam, however, the difference is that you would have never attempted the exam, but you are registered for the class, you have taken all the coursework, but something happened and you just couldn't make the exam.
Right.
And so we allowed you a makeup exam. A makeup exam, you could get whatever grade you get, A, B, C, And you're not penalized. Well, it's not a penalty, really, if you get a C in terms of the receipt, but it's saying it's trying to be fair.
Right.
So you could get whatever grade you get on a makeup exam, but it must be based on sound reasoning.
Right.
Either you were sick, but you must bring a doctor's note. You just can't show up and say you're sick. Because
right.
we get that all the time. And because for quality reason, we don't want to every day be issuing somebody an exam. Plus, it puts a strain on the lecturer having to rewrite an exam for everybody who said they were sick. And you have to control the process too. You can't just have people writing exam every week or every the same exam. It's not a tidy process. Secondly, if you have to travel, lots of students, they're on teams, cricket, football, they play for Grenada, different things, they travel on behalf of Grenada. The association normally sends a letter telling us that they swim or whatever. You know, that the student would be out representing the country. We take that and we give you the makeup exam. So you're sick, you have to travel, or you lose a loved one.
Okay.
And you have to go to a funeral, you have to help with preparing and all of that. You bring something and, you know, let us know that that happened. It must be with evidence, because we don't want a situation where you just come in every time asking for a makeup, because for flimsy reason cannot be verified.
Okay.
And that's the difference with the makeup. So a makeup is you never attempted the exam, the receipt. You have attempted and did not pass.
Right.
But if you pass with a low, well, you did not pass, but you did not fail outright.
Right.
You get like a D or a C minus.
Right.
So that's the difference. If you fail, however, you have no shot of a receipt
right.
or makeup. You have to retake the course. Maybe you got a C minus, a D. It's not, you know, it's not F. Once you don't get an F.
Right. Okay, that's understood. Mm-hmm. All right. Now, there are persons who, from time to time, would have finished TAMCC for a while, and they want to enter into some other tertiary institution, and they will need to request a transcript. What is the real process for requesting a transcript?
Right. It's very simple. You do an application. You come in. You pay the application fee. And we process your transcript for you. The thing about it, we get lots of requests from people who are former students who are abroad. We don't have, any means of collecting the money other than coming in and pay. So you'd have somebody come in and pay, make the submission, you give them all the information, and we process it. You pay for your courier. Institutions do not accept students' transcript if they're issued by them.
Right.
So we normally send it from our institution to the institution. So we do all that internally. You pay us, you tell us where you want it to go, and that's it. You just we send it off for you.
Okay, so it's a really easy process. All you need to do is just have someone on the island who will do the payment for them.
That's
and
correct.
The application, and it can be done.
Mm-hmm.
Great. So I think the last thing we want to talk about would be certificates.
Mm-hmm.
The certificate process, we have a little situation where persons don't come in and collect their certificates. If after 4 years, 5 years, can they still call in and say they would like to have the certificate?
For now, yes.
Okay.
For now, they can get the certificate. And we're appealing. Come and get your certificate. We don't know why students will, alumni will go through the process. They would have made the requirement. And for some reason, they just leave the certificates with us. The institutions, they can take the decision to destroy them after a number of years.
Right.
We don't want to do that, but we want people to come and get their certificate.
Great.
Just, come in with your ID and we do our research and we issue them to you.
Nice. So, viewers, you've heard, you can still get your certificates regardless of how long you would have attended TAMCC if you never did collect your certificate. We are running close to our time, so what we will do, we'll just discuss graduation and the rings and picture taking and so that persons have an idea what is happening as it relates to graduation coming up. So, Ms. Neptune, in a very short one sentence or two sentences, can you tell us when is graduation and what are some of the perks towards graduation, or maybe is there a cost for graduation fee and all of these things.
Right, and graduation is on the schedule for the 21st of July at the Grenada National Stadium. All students who are expected to be graduating this year must meet with their advisors. They must go through all their courses, make sure they have the appropriate grade of C within the gen eds and their majors, make sure their GPA is above two and above, and make sure they have at least 60 credits. And that's how you meet the requirement for graduation. There are variation with courses, but you know, mainly that's what it is. We have rings available, believe it or not, if you want to promote that. We have rings, and we also giving the students the opportunity to take their pictures before the ceremony, and they can get the opportunity to take at the ceremony. But you can get a professional photo taken before, and then you can take at the ceremony. I don't want to give too much information yet, because we are still discussing it. We are still, but we know the date. We set the date since last year, and so that's much I can say.
Right. And what I wanted to say to our viewers is that we'll have an upcoming program again.
Yes.
When we're going to inform them a little bit more as to what's going to really happen, guest speaker in terms of theme and all these things, and what is required by the students, as maybe how many invitees and all of that. So there's a lot more information that we can share with you as it relates to graduation. But I think our program today was very well informed. A lot of information was shared. Miss Neptune did a wonderful job as usual. So I want to thank you, Miss Neptune, for being on our program today.
You're welcome.
Think beyond, and we take you from where you are to where you want to go. That is the motto of TAMCC. I am Christina Hines, Corporate Communications at TA Marischal Community College. I want to thank you for viewing our program today, and look out for our next program as we continue to share to you what our homegrown college has in store for you, TA Marischal Community College.